choppers a throwaway. Hustle the overweight. That's why they follow me, huh? They think I know the way. Cause I took control of things. Ballin' the solo way. And if you pattern my trend, I make you my protege. Slossin' that soldier race. Hey everybody, this is Jason Matthews. Thank you for coming to our YouTube channel. Today, we're going to talk about inflation. Right now, we hear tons of talks about inflation. So today, we're going to talk about why you're hearing and seeing the tons of talks about inflation, how you combat it, and different strategies you could do to fight inflation in your own pockets. So the reason why you're hearing tons from inflation, we hear from Michael Burry, the guy from The Big Short. We're hearing from Ray Dalio. We hear from numerous people about around the financial experts and gurus a lot right now about inflation is because last year, over the last 13 months, I should say, we have printed 40% of all the money supply that we have ever printed. Once again, let me say this again, because this is crazy just to think about. In the last 13 months since COVID, we have printed 40% of all the money supply that has ever been printed in the last 13 months. Now, because of all that money printing, what they're saying is it causes inflation. Why? Because when you print so much money, it devalues the currency in your current money that you currently have. Once again, let me say that one more time for you. When you print so much money, it devalues the current dollars you have now because there's just so much money going out there. And because of that, we're hearing people talk more and more about the rumblings of inflation. Now, right now, if you listen to the people who have controlled money, the Federal Reserve, who has the power to print the money, they're talking about no inflation. But as individuals here, we are seeing inflation in our own eyes. If your lumber costs have drastically went up, we're seeing home prices drastically go up. We see stocks. Pump your gas. I have never seen gas $5 a gallon in my life. And we're seeing it now today. So I think the average individual and consumer is seeing inflation more than ever. But at the same time, we are seeing ultra-low interest rates. So here's a couple strategies we could do to fight inflation. One is the rich get richer during inflation because they have assets, not just watches, cars, and boats, but they have actual assets. And now if you go to third world countries, if you look at Venezuela at the time or Zimbabwe when they had hyperinflation, people who had electronics actually did quite well because they were able to trade those electronics because those items' values went up. But here in the United States, when we see inflation, there's a couple things that can help you is assets such as stocks and real estate and gold are usually a trend for inflation. Now, when it comes to cryptocurrency, we hear some people say it's the fighting of inflation and why you see crypto and Bitcoin going up. But you have somebody like Michael Burry from The Big Short who doesn't believe in it and thinks it's going to be a big bubble and you cannot believe that any of the Bitcoin crypto is a hedge for inflation. So you want to buy things that are hedging towards inflation. Also, because of inflation, you don't want to lock in your money for long term. Because of one way that the government can fight inflation is by increasing interest rates. Now, back in October, interest rates for the 10-year yield was at historical lows at 0.5%. Now, if we look at it today, it has more than tripled as it has been recorded at a little bit over 1.76% for the 10-year treasury, which is the denomination we currently look at. If we follow that trend, that should tell us that we don't want to lock in our money for very long rates as interest rates are continuing to go up. At the same time, we're going to see that if we have current bonds that we have, the value would go down. So what that tells us? Don't keep your interest rates. If you have anything that's interest rate sensitive, you don't want to have your money tied to that as long term. You want to find things that don't correlate with typical things that does not go with inflation. So once again, look at assets, gold, look at real estate, look at stocks, the assets that continue to grow during inflation. At the same time, you want to make sure you're not locked into long term rates on the money that you do have in your safe places as interest rates will go up. Also, be very cautious and mindful of your bonds and dividends your bonds and your stocks with dividends as bond prices and values will continue to decrease as new bonds are going to get issued at higher rates. If you follow those couple of things, you'll be doing great. The third thing is don't just get capped off on just your salary because with inflation, your inflation is going to beat your salary and the money and the value that you get with your salary is going to be worth less and less and less.
You need to find things that are asset producing that give you instant cash flow and dividends that are passive that will continue to go up with inflation. Now, if you have any other questions, those are just three quick tips on inflation. Give us a call at 510-229-7608. But more importantly, hit that subscribe button. Let us know what your thoughts are. Do you think we have inflation? Do you think we have deflation? Let us know. Talk to you later.